Guys, do
my name is Roger Smith, and I own Enviro Logix Industries. And what we do is we put in rain harvest systems, and I have a master plumber's license I've had for over 30 years. I'm a water supply protection specialist, master endorsement. I also am accredited with ARC.
This is the sturdy attachment.
So that up there detects rain and shuts off the irrigation system.
That's a rain sensor.
Yeah.
And that works.
And this is the pipe, the PVC.
Yep.
Done in crushed rock, too. Now, what do you call this rock?
This is decomposed granite.
This is the decomposed granite. Okay.
I'm telling you about it. And it's great because water goes foom right through it. It doesn't stick to your feet like sand does.
Uh-huh. And it allows the water to go into the aquifer.
Right. And then
here's your...
It's got solar energy, too.
Yeah, they all got solar energy. That's PV. That's that, you know, it spins the meter backwards when you're not around.
Uh-huh.
And it anywhere. I mean, you know quality.
So that's galvanized. It's never going to rust.
Never going to rust.
Now, what's this little device right here?
That's a light that shined up. That's an up light.
An up light. Okay.
Yeah.
Probably solar or 12 volt.
No.
It's power operated.
What happens with PV is that when the sun shines during the day and you're not using electricity, your meter spins backwards and it goes back to the transmission lines. So then, you know, you're saving the electricity that you put back into the system. All these pipes go underground and come up, right?
Right.
The beauty of your system is that back part, I'm gonna go overhead, so if anything ever happened, bombing or whatever on the ground, you still got water. You'll still get water.
Always got water.
Right,
yeah.
Either on top or down low.
Yeah.
But what happens is, you know, of course, it goes underground. And then it comes up.
Well, here's some more of that decomposed granite again.
It's always on the side of these new houses. They basically put these houses on the footprint of these lots.
So you don't have to mow grass in a bad place. You can put whatever landscaping you want. It helps the groundwater.
Everything.
Yeah.
And here's the beauty of it, because I designed these systems that the irrigation will take care of itself with rainwater. But they chingled me on this because they couldn't get the Zoysia Palisades grass. So they put St. Augustine in, and you know what, it takes 10 times the water for this as it does Palisades, and Palisades is a nicer looking grass. I don't know if you've seen it or not.
Yeah.
Yep. See, this is, you can still see water here. This is that first wash that comes out, and this is the reason why this has got water, because it just rained last night.
Yeah.
But this is your first wash.
Now, what do you mean by first wash? Explain that to me.
Okay, you see that thing that's down in there?
Yes.
Okay, first wash, and I can show you even better how that works when we get Melissa. First wash, what happens is you get rain on your roof.
Right.
And the first, you know, bird duke, and the first water off the roof is you don't want to use it. So it comes down through the pipes, and when it gets to this right here has a fitting, a big fitting that's a T. And so when the water comes down, it runs past that fitting and then it goes from 4 inch to 6 inch, and then I make it however long I need to for the first wash to get rid of. This pipe fills up with water. When this pipe fills up with water, then there's a ball inside of there that pushes against the receiver here, and it stops the water. It goes up and into the tank.
Ah, leaving behind all of the junk.
And then when the rain event's over, then this drains the system because you don't want water in your system, see?
Right.
This is your fill line that comes from the street.
Okay, so this is a 2,500 gallon tank. Okay. And that's a pretty solid plastic, isn't it?
It's you know, if I were gonna, you know, like I have at my place in Melissa, I bought tanks. I get what you call an eclipse liner on the inside. You got a green tank or whatever color. I wanted brown. And to get a lighter color tank, you don't want sun. Sun is your enemy.
Yes.
So on eclipse liner, when it's rotisserie molded, they have a packet that blows up and it coats the inside of it black. So nothing can get through it. You can get a buckskin color tank, but it's bulletproof. No sun can get through it.
Bulletproof. I like that. Yeah. You got some steel reinforcement
that's
here.
That's all sunk in there. Yeah. That's the difference.
Is this in concrete too?
Yes.
So this protects the PVC from anything happening.
No, this is the PVC. This is just holding.
No, I understand that, but this protects the PVC.
Yes. Uh-huh. But this holds it in place.
Yeah.
And this goes 3 foot underground with concrete. There's a lot of things I do different than.
What's this little thing right
that's
here?
That's just your tank gauge.
That's the float on the inside. Yeah.
Inside.
Okay. So how do you tell, just by looking at this, how full the tank is?
This just moves up and down with the tank. This particular one hasn't been adjusted. This is brand new. But that's how you can feel the tank fully. Just this thing has to be adjusted out. And that needs to be tightened. This never.
Now, how do you know that needs to be tightened?
Because you can see water right here.
Oh yeah. It's leaking out. Yeah, okay.
That's not a big. This I don't like this. The city made me do this. This they make me dump the water into the sanitary sewer in Dallas, and they throw you in jail in most places for that.
Yeah, for sure.
And so I have to do so. This has a P trap, and it runs way over there and ties into the sanitary sewer, and that's a mess. This is your pump station.
Okay, now tell me what this pump does.
This pump is the one that where you see this fitting on the bottom coming out of the bottom of the tank down there?
Yes.
That goes under there to the pump. So when you go in the garage and you call for the irrigation to turn on, it turns this pump on and boom, irrigates.
Okay, so this is the pump that operates the irrigation system. That's it.
That's it.
Other than this, you have water in the house because of gravity, basically. This is higher, or the guttering system is higher than the tank.
And gravity fills it up.
So you don't have to have any pump or anything like that.
No.
It just fills up.
Yeah,
now, what about the water getting from here into the house?
This is just
irrigation.
This is just irrigation.
Right. But if you wanted to tie this into the home.
I'll show you. Don't you worry.
Okay, I'll see that in Melissa.
You're going to see, yeah. This is... And what I seen, the one in Melissa, man, where I this is the first system ever like it. What I did was after all the pipes went and they came to the end, I buried a 540-gallon potable water tank, and then I suspended a real low-volume pump to it. And so what happens is that I get even the dew that comes off the house.
Oh, wow.
I'm mind-boggled by this project because it's getting so much more water than it's even supposed to.
Wow.
And
this thing fills up pretty quick, I suspect.
Yeah. And that's why it's important that they use the right stuff on here. This grass is going to use too much water.
Now, if the power goes out, is this pump tied into the solar system?
Yeah, it'll run off the. It can on this house because it's PV. It didn't have a battery.
Right.
But if it had a battery, absolutely, you'd have water.
Okay.
But
because there's no battery, it's likely not going to run the pump.
Unless it's daytime.
Daytime,
it will. Okay. Now, people that put in potable water systems all have solar backup.
Right.
I haven't done one yet that didn't.
Yeah, okay.
Tube comes from the second to the first.
Yeah.
That's when you shotgun the water. That's because it wasn't feasible for me to catch that water over there unless I shotgunned it to here. So it was a little more fizzy, but I had to.
That's only a 4-inch gutter, right?
That's only a 4-inch gutter.
So what we're planning is six inch. Yeah.
6-inch gutter.
Yeah, because it's got more roofing and.
Right.
Yeah.
He wanted the 4-inch gutter because of the visual, the brick and the wood. And he wanted wood below the gutter, and I don't know why, but you know what? I do what. You know.
Yeah, what they want.
Right.
I just want to look at this. They've got chickens and.
Oh, we're going to walk through there.
Wow, there's their hen house. And a tank. How big is that tank?
30,000 gallons.
30,000. So that's bigger than what we're looking at.
If we had room, we'd put it. We just don't have room. But you know what? First it had asphalt shingles. Took all that off and came back with Kynar 500 and put our filtration system on it. And then out of the bottom of this tank, this is more decomposed granite. Out of the bottom of this tank, it goes to 6-inch, and then this is 34 feet, which every 1,000 square foot, you need 10 gallons of water for your first wash, that bad stuff.
Okay.
Now, I made this one bigger because they have chickens and such, and I just wanted to be sure that we got what. Now, here's the deal. This is the most efficient system there is with this tank here. And if you look down here, you can't. The first wash is full, of course, because it was. The first wash is deep because of this tank, because that's your level. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So you have to do something a little different. I built this. There's nothing but a.
And you call this?
This is a rain garden.
A rain garden. And a rain garden doesn't necessarily have to be a hole in the ground.
No.
It can be landscaping. It can be anything that where the water ends up going to and permeating back into the aquifer. Okay.
And see this.
See, it all makes sense when you sit here and look at it that way.
And here's the thing. See, I have to calculate how much water goes into this, and so when I do, then I come back and I make 2-foot holes, 4 to 6 foot deep, and I fill those with decomposed granite, then I cover it up and staple it. So this particular one has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 holes in it, That way, when with the water that comes from the overflow, see, this is the overflow from your tank.
So if it's too much rain, then it goes back into
boom, immediately. Yeah. That way it doesn't kill your plants, because see, we'll eventually put mulch and stuff in there in the plants. Okay. Not real hardy, but this
What's the name of this grass again?
This is Zoysia palisades.
Palisades,
this is that what I was telling you. See, every bit of this is
This stuff needs very little water.
I got it at my house. It needs like 250 gallons a week.
Well, there you go.
Let's build a pond and capture every bit of the water. So that's what we did. We built a pond. Got a liner that goes in it. The dirt out of your pond, you bring over here. What I'm going to do is form berms, and that's where the orchard's going to plant. See,
so the what? The what's going to plant?
Orchard.
Orchard. Okay.
Apple orchard. We'll have olives. You're going to have peaches, pears.
Oh, cool.
Different kinds of things.
So you basically just dug a big old hole here for the water to run off into, and you'll collect it here.
This will fill up with water.
Right.
Yep. This will fill up with water, and then also I'll make berms out of these and use the trees and stuff for fertilizer in them, and then I'll make berms and we'll build our orchard, so every bit of water on this whole 150 acres will utilize.
Wow, that is cool.
That's
stuff.
Cool. People that raise the chickens for them. Over there, we've got a solar array coming in, and so it's all going to sit over there away from their house, but they're going to be 100% solar powered.
Oh, holy cow.
And they're
going to
have, they'll have four Tesla batteries in the house. And then also there'll be one large wind turbine that'll be on top of the hill.
Wow.
So now on that tank down there, the pump on this system is inside the tank, and it pumps the water underground to the filtration house, which is over here. That's why I put that tank in there.
Okay, so that is a 6-inch guttering, and that's got the same 200 micron.
Yeah, 400 micron.
400 micron.
Over the top of it.
Okay.
That's my signature. I don't know anybody. That's the only way to do it in my mind. You want to immediately filter that water.
Yeah, why not?
Right. Why not?
Why have it go into that washer?
Why? Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
They fill it.
Your crew's in New Mexico.
Right, but the people, I have someone set up to do your job that I work with all the time on my projects in Dallas and stuff.
Okay.
My deal is that I'm hands-on. I'm there.
Yeah,
I'm there 100%.
You're supervising it. That was one of my questions. Okay, so this is the filtration house. This is quite a ways away from the house.
It pumps the water, and the water comes, the water comes into here.
Right.
And this is where the water comes in.
Right.
Okay, and then
comes in from
the tank.
The tank, okay.
The tank. Water comes in from
the tank.
And
the tank is a long ways away.
Way over there.
Yeah,
220
feet. But it's downhill.
That doesn't matter because they're the pumps inside the tank. I made a hose system where I put the pump in a PVC cartridge.
Okay.
Then I put a stainless steel disconnects that you pop it to, and I suspended it from the ceiling, and it's freaking awesome.
Okay.
But anyway, it pumps.
So this is the water purification system.
The water purification system. It goes this goes down. This takes you from 400 micron to 20 micron. This. Then this is a carbon block, and it filters it even further down. So at this point here, you're more pure than you are with sodium lithium by
a long shot. Yeah.
UV lamp. And then it goes through it. This is a meter that meters the water that goes through it. This is that three-way valve I was telling you about. This thing right here, this is activated. This rainwater goes, and then this goes out to your house. Now, let's just say that the tank gets too low.
Right.
When that happens, it sends a signal to this. This valve switches, and this is city water.
City water,
that
and
goes
this is
in
rainwater.
No, this is rainwater.
Oh, this is rainwater, but it comes down here.
No, it
goes in here. Yeah, okay, that's the out.
Yeah, and then this is city water.
Right.
And then that way, when this thing switches over, it puts city water into the system. That way.
Okay, and here you can just go ahead and clean out the lines or fill up a bucket or whatever you want to do. Yeah, just an extra little faucet.
Yep. And see, this is an RPZ. This is with a seal. If the pressure falls below a certain amount between these two gauges, meaning my filters are beginning to stop, shuts the system off.
So that means you don't get any water.
Well, it goes to city water. You don't realize.
It automatically goes to city water.
You immediately taste.
You'll taste the difference.
Smell it. Right.
Yeah.
But you don't want that to happen. So, but you know, to me, see, I'm a water supply protection specialist. I'm licensed by the state to do that. So, I absolutely, positively, don't compromise when it comes to that.
Yeah. Well, that is, so if this shuts down and it goes to city water, how do you know to come out here and it's a taste, you notice the water difference. Yeah, so then you come out here and do what?
You'll look at the gauges and see what's going between those, and then you'll call me probably, but that's what they'll do. But if you were me, you'll come and look at the filters and check those.
Okay, well, you answered another question. Who do we call for service?
I have people that's all they do is the service.
But as far as a warranty on the equipment, I'm assuming it's passed through from whatever the manufacturer provides.
Right.
All right, so we got lots of things going on here today. Looks like we're digging some holes for the drainage pipe. It's all be done by hand. Yeah, they're going deep there. Now, when are these guys going to be finished up, you think? Today. So
here's where we save the money. We've only get the sprinkler line one time. We broke the sprinkler one time, so we got one repair right here on the sprinkler. But see, since I hand dug all this, it's going to be whole much better than cutting these wires and all this stuff.
Yes. Yep, absolutely. He's basically done the prep work on the fascia boards.
Let's see all the caulking.
Yep. So he's got most of the prep work done.
Right.
Okay. Well, that's great.
It's something. You're right. But you know, and Josh likes the idea. This is so cool that we can use this one deal as its own little system. That is so cool. I like that.
Back in the corner here, we're going to take an area that's about 6x8. 7x8?
7x7.
7x7, okay.
And you're going to go over 8 foot. So see, here's what you're thinking about doing. So you might as well go, instead of going 8 foot, you might as well go to here with your shoe.
Go to the stud, sure. Yeah. Yep.
And then what I'm going to do is I'll put my pump in.
And he's going to go ahead and heat trace all the water lines like it's a northern climate, so we'll never have to worry about it freezing up.
Pump's going to sit here. I'm going to pour a little pad for the pump. The pump's going to sit here.
Right.
And then we're going to come out of the pump and go into the disinfection system. We're going to set a meter in here. For $125 or $200 more if you make it Wi-Fi, why not, right?
Yeah,
the
be great.
One app you can look and you can adjust.
Our solar and our water harvesting all in one app.
See, this is what happens is that you're going to, every bit of your water for everything you're going to use out of your tank anyway, it doesn't matter, okay? The three-way valve, the only thing that it did
automatically
was
switch.
Well, yeah, when it got, it automatically switched to city. Okay, well, the only difference is that this is going to go straight into the tank, but when you put city water in there, we're building what you call a biofilm. In other words, that helps us with our bacteria. And so when you put city water in there, it kills that biofilm, and it's not good. I mean, you're still going to have pure water, but not as pure as you could have. And so eventually when we get the three-way valve, it'll be a better situation because we won't be killing the biofilm in there.
Right.
I mean, I'm spending $800 on an aeration system in these tanks. It's a new deal I've started doing, and it really makes the biofilm grow. And that biofilm attracts bad bacteria, and it just sometimes the water's so pure out of the tank, it's unreal. And Melissa, that has 7,000 parts per million of solids per liter, the city water.
Wow.
Your rainwater will have zero. Has zero turbidity, so that's a big deal. Big deal.
Wow.
Roger, that what I wanted to get done first was the soffit behind the fascia so that we can get the gutter up so he could proceed with what he wants to do.
Here's where our water comes in here onto the property, the city water. And you can see the pipe's already hooked into the system there. Good job. That was easy. Well, they're getting that tank up fast. Started this morning, huh? How you doing?
Doing well. How about yourself?
Looks like I missed out on most of the fun.
Yes, sir. We're almost there.
Yeah. What time? are going to fill this new tank that we've got installed with about 6 inches of city water, and then we're going to wait for the rain to fill it up, and then you'll come out again and you'll swap over. So we're now full, which all we need is two or three real good hard days of rain probably, and it'll be filled up.
It's coming in a few days.
Getting the painting going. Should be all done here shortly. And this is Tuesday, and a week from now we'll be putting the guttering up.
Totally stainless steel pumps. This is an inch and a quarter. This 5.5, I upsized the pump a little bit. They use a permanent gyro magnet in there, so that shrinks the size of the pump, and that's good. It gives us more room, less heat, and everything else. This is all stainless steel, everything, the construction of it, everything.
Yeah, the waterproof sheetrock, it's not proof, but it's resistant. Water resistant. Yeah, right. Really helped. Okay, and so this is the purification system here.
You see how much bigger this one is than the last one you saw?
Yeah, it is.
It's because we have more volume of irrigation and stuff that we have to do. So, but see what I did is, this is 1 inch, this is 1 inch. It comes full size into here, inch and a quarter,
right.
Comes up 1 inch. And then I leave the port 1 inch, and so even my water meter, you know, the price gets big, but it's a 1 inch water meter because that way I don't, you know, slow the water down. I don't port the water.
Right.
And so that water meter, you'll have some other stuff here. Water meter will fit on this side. I'm going to leave this open, so eventually we'll put our three-way valve.
Right.
And then we tie in right there, and it goes out.
Okay, great. Here we've got pretty much all the equipment in place, the guttering up, the drainage system's in, we've taken care of the grass, extra concrete, and now here's where the water comes onto the property here. And what do we have down here?
This is the water into the property, and what we've done, we've tied into this water, and this goes to the air gap that's the fill for the tank. So when your tank...
Now the air gap is located where?
On top of the tank.
Okay, and so this line goes all the way back to the tank, which is behind the garage, way over there.
Yep.
Okay.
It fills with the switch.
Okay.
And then once it goes through the filtration unit, it comes back through here, and then we tie into the irrigation system, and you have a valve here on the irrigation system, and then you come over here, we valve it off, and this is where we tie into the house water once our testing is done.
Okay, so once the testing is complete and all's good, then we tie back into the house system.
To the house system, then we come right past here, sever this and cap that. And so no more. The only city water that you ever have is just your fill for emergencies if it doesn't rain in forever and your tank gets dry.
Okay. But for the time being, what we've got is an irrigation system that is served by the tank.
100%.
And we're just waiting to hook the city water into the system. And how is that backflow handled? Explain that short and sweet in layman terms.
The backflow is the only backflow they worry about is on this city line.
Right.
It goes to potable water.
Yeah. They don't want any backflow from here, from the water well, going into the city water system, basically.
Right. The backflow. Right. Is the best there is. It's called an air gap. It goes up, there's a gap.
And where is that located?
On top of the tank.
On top of the tank, yes.
So it's impossible to have backflow. It's just not possible.
Okay.
It's the best air gap there is, or best backflow device there is.
And once the city sees that, then they're going to, and when the water's been tested and everybody buys off on it, we come back here and we hook the rest of the system up.
Tie it in.
Yeah.
Cap it off, and then you're rainwater.
We're done. All right. Okay, we're back at the tank area here. Everything, all the work has been pretty much complete. Hoping for some rain this weekend, which if we get a real good rain for 2, 3, 4 days, that should fill up that 20,000-gallon tank, I would imagine.
Should.
Okay, and why don't you give me an update what we've got here? I see all sorts of piping coming from this guttering. There's a filter up there that's 400 micron,
yep,
I believe.
400 micron.
Okay, and then it's going through this PVC here, and then heading off towards here. So
this is your alternative water source. That way, if something happens to your underground system, then you've always got this going into your tank.
Off the garage.
Off the garage. Okay. So it's just a perfect situation because things can happen. And if they do, then you're always going to be good.
So the underground that's coming from the house is supplemented with what's coming from the garage.
Right, that's correct.
Yeah, okay.
And see, the thing is I'm a big believer in first wash. I don't want to put a first wash right now because actually when you have solar panels, you don't have the kind of buildup and stuff that you have when you have a shingle roof. So we'll be catching a lot. We'll monitor that. And if we need to, we'll put a little first wash in. Not a big deal. But for now, we'll do this to maximize our water intake.
Okay, great.
See, you see the air gap up there on top?
Yes.
You get an aluminum jacket on this insulation. But the air gap goes through there, so there's no way that it can backflow. It's on top of the tank.
Yes.
And there's a gap.
It would have to jump up.
It's impossible.
Yeah, yes.
And see, there's a screen inside the bottom of that. That's one thing I've specially built. There's a screen in there that sits down in. So here's the
view. Wow. That's a nice little, what do we call this?
This is a rain garden.
A rain garden.
This is a custom made, yes. See, what will happen here is we'll bust all that concrete off, we'll clean that pipe up, and then we'll paint it the same color as the tan pipe there, you see?
Uh-huh.
And so when we do that, that'll match that better, use a little more pea gravel, and that's your first wash.
Okay, what's this we have over here, this pipe?
We don't have to fill the tank up so much that it overflows, but if it does, we have an overflow. Okay.
And that's going to go into the drainage ditch. Yeah. Yes. Well, here's an example of the other garage roof where we've got a real good solid pipe, again with that 400 micron filter up there. And this goes directly into the underground pipe that heads back to the water tank there. And that's the same situation as we have on the house, where we've replaced the guttering there with 6-inch guttering. And again, those 400 micron filters and all that goes down, this hard pipe that goes underground and into the system that by gravity feeds the water tank. That's pretty awesome.
It's got a 1% fall from A to B. Was shot with an instrument so we can manipulate the flow of the water. We need the water running at a certain gallons per minute in order for this to work correctly.
Okay. How many gallons per minute are we going to end up with, you think?
166.
Okay. And again, another pipe, water coming off the roof, headed back to the tank. And we got the same situation back in here, too. So pretty much applies everywhere. The thing, Roger, this line here is the one, this water line here, is the one that's tapped into all the roof guttering systems, and by gravity, the water from the roof, which is 6 feet above the top of this tank, will,
42 inches
above, will go into the water line, or this water line pipe here, and into the tank, and fill up the tank, and once the tank is full, if that was to happen, then the overflow that we looked at yesterday is right here, and it will go off onto the property.
That's correct.
System. So this conduit with the hose inside of it runs back to the pump, which that runs constantly generating air
to aerate
the tank. Okay.
And build your biofilm.
And this insulated water line here actually comes back from the city service, and what's going to happen is a solenoid that's inside here. Once the float valve inside the tank falls, this solenoid will call for city water to come from back there in this line, this insulated line, and up into that air valve or air gap, and then into the tank. And the air gap that's up there prevents any backflow. So is that pretty much
perfect? Backflow prevention.
Okay, so the city was concerned that you had had two different directions. Go ahead and explain that.
They were talking about the water going into the house and then the water hooked up to the rainwater tank, and that's not what we have. We tied into the city water, and we have an air gap at the tank, which there's no way for backflow. And then eventually, when we tie the house in after we do our testing, we'll separate the city water, put a cap on it.
And that'll happen right here.
It'll happen right here. And the rainwater will tie into this and go into the house. So you never have a connection with the potable water that's not protected by either an RPZ or an air gap.
Okay, and they're good with that now?
And they're good with that.
So now the process will be to get the tank emptied of the city water that's in it now, get it filled up with strictly rainwater, and then send it off to the lab to get it tested.
Testing, right.
And the adhesives or the sealants they're using on the solar panels,
They're good. It's, you know, and I haven't done my research, but I sent a text, they have a data bank. And so they ran that through the data bank, the panel types and stuff, and they've all been good. But we'll still, double check to make sure.
Sure.
But the way it stands, we're good.
Right. Okay, and it still wouldn't hurt, though, to go ahead and put in an RO unit in the house here, just as an extra precaution.
That's probably a great idea.
A great idea.
Yeah.
Okay.
You know, that RO unit isn't like $119.
Yeah.
And it's real.
Well, our solar panels are going up rather quickly. It looks like they're right on schedule. The weather's been cooperating.
Yeah.
They started yesterday morning. They've already got one garage done. And they're working on the second roof.
And they
so
got the,
they got solar panels on the done on the first roof here, and here's what that looks like. And it's not that unattractive at all. And then over here, they're working on the second roof. And you can see the braces that they put in on the roof, and they attach the panels to that. Here's what a panel looks like.
This is just all the guts controls. This will be covered up. You won't ever have to really get back into this.
Okay.
Unless we have issues. And then sometimes it's just a computer board we have to swap out.
Okay.
This is our DC connections and our AC connections. Our AC connection goes from here outside to that disconnect.
Yes.
And then comes into here.
Okay.
So to kill it, hit the disconnect outside, everything's off.
Where would the Tesla battery go in the future then? Somewhere over in here?
Somewhere here, they're wall mount.
Yep, it's wall mount.
They're wall mount.
Okay.
And not exactly sure how the tie-in is going to be, but I know they're working with Solar Edge, working with SMA, working with all the major manufacturers.
Okay.
Yeah. NSF 61 is a government designation for drinkable, you know? I mean, even like, it's weird because I got a brass nipple that's 1.25 from Apex in town here. Come to find out, it has lead in it. And even though it has a tiny amount of bit of lead, I can't use it. And so when we test for heavy metals, it'll show up. You know, it'll either be negative or positive. It's positive, and we'll find out what it is.
Yeah, no working. Did you look at the sealant, or even our silicone too? Our caulk? Was that part of it?
It's in they're looking at it in a database. It goes through a database. And the thing is that you're never going to be perfect. You're always going to have something. You filter that out.
Yeah.
But you just try, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Just like Bobby said, he's correct about the ions being, you know, like a hundredth of a micron.
Yeah.
But the thing about that is that it's not even anywhere near enough to affect you. And there's less that's in city water.
Right.
So it doesn't really.
City water, I think you told me, has 7,000 parts per million of stuff. And so this rainwater is going to have not zero, but close to it, huh? Zero. Yeah.
When you're done, clean it up.
TES, total. Yeah. Even right now, out of that tank, it's not going to have. I've looked at it. You can see, it's pretty clear. It's good water.
I know this stuff. I've been putting these systems in for over 10 years.